Join me now in the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing for the singing of the National Anthem and the Pledge of Colors. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you for sharing this experience with us, and we hope you enjoy the Franklinton High School class of 2020. Ms. Trisha Smith. Supervisors, Ms. Jennifer Benamico and Ms. Amanda Stafford. Visiting principals, Ms. Karen Crow, Ms. Shannon Fowler, Ms. Rachel Stonehall, and Ms. Tiffany Smith. Board members, President Dr. John Weibel, Mr. Scott Freeland, Mr. Keaton Miles, and Mr. David Petit. And any other central office staff. Please stand, Senator Beth Mizell and Sheriff Randy Steele.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Franklinton High School graduation ceremony. It is a thrilling Thursday evening in the town of Franklinton. What an honor it is to stand before you tonight and give these students their diplomas. Students, this diploma is a key. It's a key that will open doors. The doors to your future. What lies beyond those doors is different for each of you. Different opportunities, different journeys, different careers, different challenges, different people and circumstances. And life can seem complex at times, but every journey will require the same basic principles to be successful. So I felt it was important to reflect on your generation and things you have experienced during your lifetime in order to simplify this process for you. I thought about all types of things, games, toys, TV shows, and events. Remember Ripsticks, GameCubes, iPods, Heelys, American Girl dolls? What about events like Katrina and COVID? Yes, these are our Katrina babies, ladies and gentlemen. They've come a long way. We were not going to let thunderstorms tonight in Franklinton deter us from honoring these students. So Katrina, who could ever forget it? It even brought some of you to our area to attend Franklinton High School. Our world was turned upside down. You were babies, but your parents were forced to evacuate and hunker down in a safe place. But when the storm passed, they assessed the situation. They developed a vision and a plan for what they wanted to get things back to normal for each of you. Students, that vision, that dream is what you have to do. You must have a dream and a vision for where you want to be down the road, what lifestyle, what type of career, what type of house you want to live in, what type of car you even want to drive. Have a vision for where you want to be. And remember, Katrina, your parents had a vision. They had a vision of AC, a working refrigerator, and all the comforts that we needed. That vision drove us to drive hours and wait in lines to get generators and all the things that we need to provide comfort for you. It also takes a plan, a map. Your goal for service, your map. Help you reach your destination. As you work towards your goal, you will also have to make sound decisions. Will this put me closer to what I want to accomplish towards my vision and my goals? Or will it take me further away? And you will be challenged to ignore those choices that make you feel better right now, to make the decision on what you know in your heart is best long term. Marathon runners run 22 miles and they don't stop. Even though the marathon is 26, if they stop at mile 22, they don't immediately feel better. Why do they keep running? Because they know they have a vision of completing that marathon. They're not worried about the instant gratification. They visualize the finish line. There will be times when your choices have no clear answer. I don't know if this will lead me closer. Well, students, that's when you pray. You hit your knees and you pray and you ask God to provide guidance. Your values will also be tested. So it's important to have strong values. Although every journey is different, the values of discipline, hard work, positive energy, and seeing every day as an opportunity, those values have stood the test of time. We talk weekly about the importance of a positive frame of mind. Coming here tonight, you are all smiling, excited, and happy because you had a positive frame of mind. Those things are important. Do you know that humans are actually hardwired to be cynics and skeptical? It's part of our DNA. But we have to fight that urge. Look at the blessings we're all bestowed with. Negative mindset will affect you. Don't let it. Fight that desire to be a cynic. It's proven to lead to health problems. So stay positive. You must rely on your ability to have sound relationships with mentors as well, much like your English teachers told you to do. Find somebody who is where you want to be. Spend time with them. Ask them, how did you get where you are? It's another simple concept, but it's very important. There are no shortcuts, students. It takes what it takes. Anything you pursue of value will require effort and hard work. If you spend 2 hours washing your car, it looks a lot better than somebody who spent 10 minutes washing theirs. So the time you invest in something, you get out of it. So students, remember, dream, create a vision, develop goals, make sound decisions, have strong values, develop relationships with mentors, and remember, you will get out of it what you put into it. So dream, develop a plan, and begin working tomorrow. Remember, your family will always find gratification in your accomplishments, so make them proud. And go forth and honorably represent your family, school, and community. May God bless you, and good luck. We will now have the conferring of diplomas. Ms. McGee, Ms. Landry, Ms. Sandburn, and Ms. Thomas, please join me.
Daniel J. Bryant.
Christopher.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Graduates, please move your tassel to the left side. By the authority vested in me, by the Louisiana State Department of Education, I present to you the graduating class of Franklinton High School, the class of 2023. Graduates, you may roll your clock.
Thank you.